I can hear that, but I don't have to hear everything you have to say. So it gives you a way of having sort of, you know, a power over your head. This notion of audience awareness, like, there are people that I've never met that I follow on Twitter because they say interesting things, and I feel like I really know that, like, it's getting to a point where friends who aren't on Twitter don't really exist in my world because they're not constantly popping up. I mean, it can be as simple as, you know, I made a ham and cheese sandwich today, and, you know, tomorrow I'm making, you know, peanut butter and jelly. Like, you'll have to sort of this rhythm, like, sort of get this very close look at, you know, who this person is. Now, it's still one-dimensional, you have your own meaning there, and it doesn't really mean that this person is, you know, just a sandwich maker. But it's still giving me a closeness, you know, this idea that, you know, that I can know someone without actually having to. You know, I can really know where you're at, and then we can still reconnect with you later, and it's like, you know, instant crowdsourcing. If you post a question on Twitter, if you have enough followers, you're going to get great responses. Sometimes better responses than just going to be on for an hour. Services, iPhone, you know, bringing the GPS aspect, services like Bright Kite, you know, there's other Twinkle, another good client that has sort of the studio focus. Now, my conversation doesn't just happen in this ether and cloud called the internet. It actually gives a client a place. I'm right here, right now, watching Eric talk about Twitter, right? You know, and there's sort of this other aspect in coaching. I haven't opened it in, you know, basically 7 hours. It's rebid. And now Twitter's beaten 5 minutes. You know, I mean, literally, you go, make 12 hours later, they will finally catch up with your story and how you wrote on it. When the US Airways plane crashed in the Hudson, first spoke about it, was on Twitter's phone. You know, so I showed up, I mean, there's really fairly talking about it. There was already a picture on there, you know, getting 7,000 views. And so much more. I mean, this is the platform, you know, the beats and applications that are coming. I stole that from Air, the operation. And I mean, Twitter being a system is spawned more ad accounts and different ways towards the yes that I've seen. I mean, there may actually be, or at least it's approaching that, more add-on applications for Twitter than there are on Facebook. But they can get it as a platform. Also, the API is possible. So, really, you know, to sort of sum up all of it, it's the post, it's the comment, it's the, you know, the business conversation, the unit of measurement for the conversation. Each one starts to add to the global conversation. You know, and you can see it, sort of, that I think on Twitter, pretty good. I mean, you have to go that and walk. And there's a lot of people that say that, you know, Twitter replaces their blog. You know, they don't even update their blog unless they've got something really good that they want. You know, long-winded that they want to say, but it's really not about the platform, it's not about Twitter. Twitter's just for that. It just invented the full space accidentally. You know, they thought, well, you know, let's get the whole establishment on Facebook, and we'll just build a little app around that. We've got a couple of things. It just evolved. I think it evolved beyond their control. You know, right now they've got some users, but they won't keep them, especially if they don't